www.malibuwine.com. That's malibuwine.com or 818-865-0605. Welcome back here to the PM Show Weekend Edition on CRN, the Conrad Radio Network. I'm Michael Horn, ladies and gentlemen, the true American icon, Robert Conrad, taking your phone calls at 800-336-2225. Your emails, send them to rconrad@crni.net, Conrad Radio Network Interactive.net.
Coming to you, Sue, in a minute. Kevin, what else was on your mind?
Kevin, you're back on the line there. What else did you have for Bob?
You guys hear me?
Yeah. What's up?
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm from Anaheim Hills today. I was in Florida a couple weeks ago, so one goal is to call in from as many cities as I travel to.
Good. Wow. Hey, you know what else? I love your voice, man. You sound like a gangster.
All right, well, thank you. Here's the question, and that is, I'm not sure if all these facts and information are totally correct on the internet, or that you can believe everything, but if this is true, kind of want to know your thought process and considerations in terms of why you, if it's incorrect, I apologize, but why you possibly turned down the lead role as the in the A-Team back in the early 80s.
Yeah, that is correct, and that was Stephen J. Cannell. That was his show. And
you had the he wanted you for the A-Team, huh?
Yeah, he wanted me to do the A-Team, and I just told Steve, I said, this doesn't work for me, Steve. I don't know why. I just don't feel up to it. But I did, and I am responsible for the actor that ended up playing the lead role.
George Peppard?
Was it George?
Yeah, it was
Peppard?
George Peppard.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't Peppard. Was it Peppard?
Yeah,
was the
George
lead?
Peppard was the lead there.
Yeah, he was the colonel.
Mr. T, and who was the third?
Oh, yeah, it was Mr. T, yeah. Okay, yeah, right. Peppard, of course. I'm sorry. And he's from Chicago. The black guy, what's his name?
Yeah, Mr. T.
Yeah, Mr. T, yeah.
Mr. T. He's from Chicago?
Yeah, he's from Chicago. He used to be a bodyguard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I got into it. Well, that's another story.
Oh, you got
all
another
right,
story
so
to
anyway,
get
anyway, what's your question, Kevin?
Oh, you got three fight stories here. Joy Bishop, the Cheyenne Rodeo, and now...
Can I talk to Kevin?
I'm sorry.
Kevin, is that it?
That's it today, sir. I appreciate it.
All right, and I appreciate that voice. It'd be great for you to be doing voiceovers. All right, thanks for your call, man. Keep calling.
Got a couple of lines open.
800-336-2225.
Okay, if you've been trying to get in, the lines are busy. 800-336-2225.
Doesn't he have a great voice?
He has great. He could do promos on a TV station.
Amazing. So you're next. We'll be with you in just a second, Sue. So it says here, what members of the Rat Pack were on the show? Was it a big party, and did Frank stop by?
Yeah, you didn't answer that.
That question. Well, no. Sammy did the show. Of course, he was the main center of the Rat Pack.
He did the Wild Wild West, right?
And Frank and that group didn't come by.
So Wofford didn't come by.
Well, they didn't come by the filming at all, and I appreciate that because when I went to work, I was all business.
Hey, not when Jimmy Cagney was on the set.
Well, he just sat there, and I was amazed that he came to visit.
That was pretty heavy duty.
That was as heavy duty as it gets.
Yep.
But here, anyway, we answered that.
And
so.
You didn't talk about the fight in Cheyenne, Wyoming at the rodeo. You were going to mention
the Cheyenne. All right. So anyway, I'm in Cheyenne, and I'm just thrilled, and I'm coming out of shoot number one, and it's just so damned exciting. And we went up to the level of the persons we were appearing with because those were top cowboys. I mean, those guys were the real deal, doing the rodeo stuff and getting knocked off of horses and cows. And I admired their work, but they weren't really thrilled with the Hollywood folks. And I think they thought we weren't,
weren't as tough as they were.
Yeah. So anyway, there was always a party afterwards because it was not all the time, but most of the time it was produced by different charities.
Right.
And then part of your appearance also meant you had to attend their little get together
dinner afterwards. Whatever it might be. Yeah,
it
right.
wasn't
yeah.
dinner. It was like cocktails. And
gotcha. Out. Okay. Yeah.
So I had to get with number one stuntman was Dick Canju, who wrote the book. And a lot of people have read that book, and I haven't, but congratulate him for writing it. And he was a dear friend, a former boxer and a former trainer of mine. And a dear friend. So he's there. And boxing had damaged him somewhat. His nose was in different parts of his face and, okay. and so on.
We understand.
And this guy comes up and he goes, so, hey, boy, what are you doing? Are you his bodyguard? Is that what you're doing? And Dick looked at him. He says, no, I'm your bodyguard.
Well, I guess I understand what that means.
Yeah, and I just thought, I looked at Dick, and I went, what are you doing that for? Guys had half a dozen cocktails in them, and we don't need to go there with that.
But Dick said, did protect him, didn't he?
No, Dick didn't do anything. I did.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Boom, boom. You can do that. No, it's a short right hand.
No more cocktails.
Nope. That was the end of that, cowboy. All right, let's go to Sue. Hey, Sue. Is it New Hampshire?
It's New Hampshire.
Is that how it's pronounced, New Hampshire?
New Hampshire,
it's not New Hampshire, is it?
No, it's not.
Well, we're going to go to commercial here.
Thanks for calling,
we're
Sue.
We're coming
Bye.
Back, Sue. And I want to thank you. I got something from Starbucks from a friend.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You love Starbucks coffee. That is your favorite, isn't it?
I love coffee. Don't go plugging Starbucks. Do they sponsor us?
No, they don't.
Well,
so
then
forget
move
what I
on.
Said.
Folgers. Anyway,
thank you very much.
I hear a drone. Does that mean we're going to commercial?
Yeah, we're going to a little quick break. We don't say commercial. We're just going to a break.
We're going to a quick break, Sue.
That's good, yeah.
So when we come back, we're going directly to you. Mr. Conrad, what a great American TV movie icon you are. Hollywood is sorely in need of image you portrayed on the screen. The problem is there is one and only one, Robert Conrad.
Amen to that.
Thank you for that. Conrad Falk from Chicago, and we'll talk about the Stockyards too soon.